Cheers. We're happy to be back. We love this little room. This is nice. We're going to play you guys a bunch of shit off the first record. Is that all right with you? Anyway, sprinkle in some other stuff in the middle that you probably don't want to hear, but that's all right. This next song is, this was the very first song we released off that debut album 30 years ago. I think it came out in May of 1993. This is a little love song called Change.
As I stand here, I ponder great things. See you no longer part of your lover's dream. Thank you.
Thank you.
record. Except put your hands together for our good friends from Nashville, Tennessee, opening the show tonight, the Dead Dads! Man, and McQueen, we lost Kix. Kix had to get back to Nashville. She got some work to do tomorrow. That bass player is 18 years old and unfucking believably talented. thanks for jamming with us. Don't drink all our whiskey. Back to 1993 for a minute. Right on. Last tour. time. So Fort Wayne, we're happy to be back. I've been coming to this town since 1993, man. That's crazy. Got some of my Gas City friends in the house tonight. Anybody else here from Gas City? Right on, man. Good little town. You're crazy as hell, you sons of bitches. But I like to party with you. I'm gonna play you something off of Happy Pills. Is that all right?
Quiet down.
That's when you know. I feel y'all want to sit down and stuff because I'm like, I'm 54 and my back hurts and shit. I don't need the fucking. Like I said, DC, that's what you get right there. All jokes. But yeah, thank you for standing and thank you for enjoying the show. And I hope you guys are having a great time with us tonight. And if you'd have told me 30 years ago that I'd be standing here right now, still doing this, I wouldn't have believed you. I think when we started the band, we thought that maybe we'd have an opportunity because being from Seattle and shit, that was going to work. We had no idea that it was going to be as successful as it was. And so thank you for letting us do this for 30 years. I appreciate you. And I'm pretty sure everybody here tonight has every single Candlebox record ever released. So. I don't. I only have one. I won't even listen to that first album. Anyways, this song's about the ex-wife. Her name is Renee. She was beautiful. She was amazing in the sack. But she was a Scientologist. I can only take so much crazy, you know what I'm saying? Any Scientologists here? Like one, maybe. Anyways, y'all are crazy. Love it. So this is about our relationship, and it was fast and furious and fun, and the divorce was better. So I wiped the night from my eyes, black out the sunny day, and I hide the effects on down around us. Just missing the red, yeah. And I'm happier now today. Don't let me down, let me go. Change of seasons, inside of mind, inside of mind, inside. In time I'll decide to move along, change directions. Watch the tide till we borrow too much. Form restrictions. We fall out and we separate from you. Sometimes we carry more weight than we own. Sometimes goes. Somehow we'll find a way we're gone. Back together these ripped out pages of old coloring books we own. Gold and silver mine, blue is gray, it's all held together by cellophane tape. We change directions, watch the tides, and we borrow too much. Farm restrictions, we form lines, and we I'm going to expect to see you on stage with Ozzy Osbourne at some point. So you're going to have to learn how to play guitar. Yeah? Can you do it? Can you do it? Yes, you can. You can do anything. It's going to be amazing. Enjoy that, all right? But it's another new song. We're going to play this. You guys haven't heard this one either. Hope you like it. You might not. Goes a little something like this.
Thank you.
was just asking the guys how many more shows we have. They don't know. Are you having fun?
Yeah!
Who's got to work tomorrow? This isn't really a job. We like to say it's a job, but it's fucking easy as hell.
It's an awesome job.
We just travel the world for a year and don't see our families for a long time, but it's a super easy job. I started a foundation last year called RiptideSociety.org. It's a foundation for at-risk youth and young adults in the foster care system. Are there any kids here from the foster care system that have survived? Thank you for surviving. I know it wasn't easy. And you found out that people do give a shit about you, which is important. The foster care system in the United States has got to change, folks. Those of you who don't know, if you want to look it up, it's a little bit of a scam. There are parents that should not be fostering children that do it because they get $6,000 a child. We're going to try and change that. That's what Riptide's about. We want to give these kids an opportunity. We want all that money that the government gives to those parents to go to those kids. That could be in the neighborhood of $200,000-$400,000 when they graduate at the age of 18. So if you guys would like to make a donation, we are a 100% not-for-profit charity. Every single penny goes for these kids. It's RiptideSociety.org. This song is for them. This is Riptide. I wanna live barren someday. Yeah. This song's about organized religion. We got any good Christians here tonight?
That's it?
Where are my pagans at? I was raised Roman Catholic, so I'll see you guys in hell. I was an altar boy when I was 10 years old, and this priest that was at my church, his name was Father Sean O'Shea. He was right out of Dublin. He had the most beautiful Irish brogue, and he was the kindest, most gentle human being I've ever known. And he told me at the ripe old age of 10 that I wasn't a good Catholic. Which is great for a 10-year-old to hear. I was like, Dad, I don't have to go to church anymore. He's like, the hell you don't. No, what he said to me was like, there are people that are spiritual and there are people that need to have organized religion. And he felt that I was spiritual. It was because I kind of just floated around in religion and I studied it and I read the Bible and all that stuff and I was pretty fascinated by it, but I questioned it all the time. And he said that's why I'm a little bit different, because I question what organized religion is. And there's nothing wrong with it. I think that the beauty of having that, something that you believe in and the faith in that, the hope that there's something else out there that's bigger than us, that when we leave this planet, we get to see our family that we haven't seen in 5, 10, 15 years. That's a beautiful thought, and I swear to God, I miss my dad so much, I can't wait to fucking see him, you know what I'm saying? But there's a part of me that questions that, and that's what this song's about. storm, shelter from the storm. I would love you to please put your hands together one more time for our good friends who opened up this evening from Nashville, Tennessee, the Dead Dads! The fact that Meta sang that a cappella, that's one of my favorite songs of theirs, and it was so beautiful, and I could never do that, and I just admire the fact that she's got that kind of voice, and she's got the strength to do that. So, Meta, you're beautiful. Thank you. Over the 30 years that I've been touring the world, I've come across a few bands in my career that have changed my life. Dead Deads are one of them. We've toured with the Flaming Lips. We've toured with Aerosmith. We've toured with Rush. We have toured with Metallica. But it's always the young bands that have the real talent that are the ones that surprise you. And there's a lot of great music out there, y'all. So please do yourselves a favor and listen to the Dead Deads and anything that's linked to what they're doing. Give it some love, because it will give it to you back. And this song is dedicated to some brothers of mine that I no longer get to hang out with. That would be Kurt, and Chris, and Lane, and Scott, and Mr. Mark Lanigan. But most importantly, one musician that changed my life when I was 16 years old, who told me I could do anything, his name was Andrew Wood. And he sang for Mother Love Bone, and he was an incredible talent. So Andy, this one's for you. I miss you.